Welcome back. We will make another ODE-based model. And this time, we will model the spread of infectious disease. The infectious disease spreads from one person to another when an uninfected person comes in contact with an infected one and gets infected. We will use ordinary differential equation to represent the rate of spread of such an infectious disease. To make the model, we'll make some assumptions. The first assumption is, everybody can come in contact with everyone. In the last video, we discussed that for any ODE-based model, we have to assume that the system is homogeneous. So in this case, if the system has to be homogeneous, then every person has to come in contact with the other person so that uninfected and infected person can mingle with each other. If you remember, the second key assumption for ODE-based models is that the system size is very large. So for this particular problem of infectious disease, our assumption would be that the total population is very large. Our third assumption is made to make our life simple. We want to write a simple ordinary differential equation. So we have assumed that the total population in the system remains constant. That means the number of people infected plus number of people uninfected is constant. There is no death, no birth. That reduces terms in our ordinary differential equation. Similarly, another assumption we have made to simplify the model is that no one gets cured. If you got infected, you will stay infected forever. With these four assumptions, we write down the ordinary differential equation representing the spread of the disease. We have considered the total population is constant. So we can assume that as 1. So x, the dependent variable of our model, represents fraction of the population that is infected. And our model is dx dt is equal to r into x into 1 minus x. Here 1 minus x represent uninfected people. And r is the rate constant or parameter of our model. Now I have the ODE and I want to know the time evolution of the system. If you remember, you have three approaches. Either you can analytically solve the ODE, or you can take a graphical approach, or just like the last model, you can use the numerical approach. Using a computer, you can solve the model. In this video, I will discuss analytical method to solve this particular model of spread of infectious disease. So I have the model. From that, I need to know the time evolution of the system. That means I have to represent x as a function of time. To achieve that, I will integrate the ODE. To do so, first I will separate out the term involving x and time. I can do that following way. So I have all the terms of x on this side, and this should be dt, r into dt. Now I will integrate both the sides. Let us put the integration signs. To solve this problem, you have to specify the initial condition. So initial time point is 0 and the final time point is t. At initial time point, x is x0 and the final at time t, x is x. So with this initial condition, I'll integrate. I'll skip the steps. On integration, I get this relationship. X into 1 minus x naught divided by x naught into 1 minus x is equal to e to the power rt, will rearrange these terms here so that I can separate out x and keep everything else on the right hand side. On doing so, I get this function. Here, this is my function of time, x as a function of time. So starting with this ODE, I have reached to this where I have got x as a function of time. Now using this function, I will try to answer questions about this particular problem. You may tell me the initial conditions, like how many people are infected initially. You can tell me the rate of the spread of the disease, and then you may ask how many people will be infected at a particular date. For example, you may have said initially 2% of the population is infected, and you want me to calculate the value of x, the fraction of the population infected on 20th day, such that r, the rate constant you have given, as 0.5. How can I calculate that? Very easily. Plug the numerical values here. So by plugging the numerical value, I get the following: 1 by 1 plus 1 by x naught, x naught is 2%, that means 0.02, minus 1 into e to the power minus r, r is 0.5, into t, t is 20. I have already done the calculation. You get 0.9977, which is nothing but 99.77%. That means if you start with 2% of the population infected and the rate constant is 0.5 per day, then on 20th day you will have 99.77% of the population infected. But suppose you are not asking this specific question. You want the whole time profile. You want to see how x changes with time. I can answer that very easily by plotting this function on x versus t plane. I have plotted it. Initially, x increases exponentially from a low value. And as t becomes very large, for example, suppose t reaches towards infinity, very large value, then this whole term e to the power minus rt becomes small and small. That means x reaches towards 1 asymptotically. Let us jot down the key points that we have learned in this video. To make a mathematical model, we should first make some assumptions so that we can simplify the problem. The key assumptions of ODE-based model, the homogeneity and large system size, has to be there. You may have to make some additional assumptions to make the system simpler. One way to do that is to consider conservation of variable. For example, in this particular problem, I have assumed that the total population, infected plus uninfected, remains constant. That reduces number of terms in my model. Then, once you have the assumptions, represent the rate of the process by an ODE. In some cases, for example, in the previous model, we had a system of ODE. So once you have the ODE, you get the function describing the dynamics of the process by integration. Using that function, you can answer specific questions or as a whole can get the time profile of the system. Thank you for learning with me today. See you in the next video.